there, thanks for joining me to color. Today I thought we would work on this alt new Build a Flower Anemone stamp. So we've got the anemone. It's got a bunch of really pretty parts to make this flower right here. Isn't it gorgeous? I'll put a link to this down in the description box if you would like to head over and grab one and color too. I've already heat embossed my image with some opaque white or some super bright white wow embossing powder on Arches 140 pound cold press watercolor paper, and I taped it down to this little cutting board because I'm going to be getting it wet and I want it to stay flat. So we're going to be using my Gonzai Tambi watercolors, so this palette here. And I thought we would use number 62, 64, and 67 for the flowers. And then for the leaves, I'm going to use 51 and 58. So I'm going to do, watercoloring takes quite a while to do for me because I like to let it dry in between. You can heat blast it, but it does have a totally different look, which I will show you at the end on a separate piece. But for now, we're going to let it dry in between. So every time I do a color, I'm going to let it dry and then I will fast forward the video or cut it and then come back and show you the next process when I start to repaint again. So let's get started. Okay, so to get started, I get my petals wet. So I'm gonna go ahead and start on this petal right here in the corner. And it's probably hard to see because it's white on white paper, but we're going to get it wet. My brush has a little bit of blue on it from getting my paint wet, so don't pay attention to that because we're going to paint in blue anyway. Okay, so I've got my paper all wet, and then I'm just going to pick up a little bit of color on my paintbrush, and I start down here at the bottom. Put some paint on. Let's go all the way around. And I only want the center of my flower to be yellow, so I'm going to go in this white section here and put some. Okay, and then I'm going to rinse my brush off. And just make sure it's got clear water in it. And then I want the whole petal to be blue, so I'm going to go in, my brush is still damp, and just spread this out to the edges. And we're going to do that for all the petals. Then I'm going to let that dry, but we're going to go over here and we're going to do this flower I have stamped on this side also. So I'm going to go ahead and get my brush wet, and we will get our flower petals wet. Need a little bit more water. Then we'll pick up some paint. And I'm going to dab it in the middles. And let that all flow out here into the edge. And then I want to use that paint to go clear out to the edges. I got a little bit right there that went out of the line, so I'm going to get my paint wet, or my brush wet. I'm just going to dab a little bit of water on that. And then I'll use my paper towel to pick that up. And then we're going to let that dry. So let's work on some of these leaves we have. So again, I'm going to get my leaves wet. So let's go ahead and start down here in the corner. I'm going to go ahead and just get all of them wet. And I can always put a little bit more water on if they've dried out here too. So I got one up here. And I kind of spaced them out because I'm going to cut them out later. And we'll pick up a little bit of our green here. We're just going to dab that onto our leaves. And this one's got quite a bit, so I'm going to pick some up here on my brush and I'm going to move it up here. And let's go ahead and pick up some more. And we'll add a little bit to these. I went out of lines there. Let's go ahead and rinse that off. Okay, so that's good for our first coat. We're gonna let that dry and I will come back and we will add some more color when it's finished drying. All right, so we've let that dry. So now we are going to add number 64. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my brush wet here and my paint. Okay. Now, so all right, so we've let that dry. So let's go ahead and add our second color, which is number 64. So I just got some clean water on my brush, and I'm just going to add a little bit here in the centers. So maybe a little bit along the edge of this upturned leaf or flower petal. I'm going to pick up some of my color. And we're going to add that. Little bit more. And I think I'll get my brush wet and add just a little bit of clean water along the edge here. Maybe pick a little bit of this up. That looks kind of like quite a bit. Okay, and let's do the same thing to this flower over here. So we'll add a little bit of clean water in the centers. Pick up some color. And then I'm going to soften that with a little bit of more water out here on the edge. Dilute it a little bit. Let that dry. So let's add some green to our leaves. Put some water on. Pick up some of this darker green, which was, I think it's 58. I think I got a little too much on this one. I'm going to wipe a little bit of that up. And this one's got quite a puddle too. Let's dab some of that up. Okay, so we're gonna let that dry and then I will come back. Okay, so we've let that dry. So let's go ahead and add our darkest blue, which is 67. And I'll get my brush wet with some water. And then I want to add it kind of along the edge here of this one. So I'm gonna pick some of that up. And let's see, let's do the edge of this. And then there's a few that are turned up, so I'm going to add some color on that. Let's see. One. And then I'm going to soften this edge, so I'm going to get my paintbrush wet with just water. And let's hop over here and we'll do this side. And then we'll soften our edges with some water. And I got a couple of upturned petals, so let's do in here. And for our green up here, let's see, do we need to add a little bit more to our petals? I think we might, so let's see. I'm going to need to put some more green on here. And what color were we using? 58. We'll darken up our green just a little bit on some of these leaves. So I'm just going to get them wet. And then we'll put some color on there. And we're going to let that dry and I'll come back and we will see what we can do next. All right, so I'm back after letting that dry and I'm going to go over all of this with a coat of our lightest color, which was 62. So let's get some of that on my brush. And I'm just going to go over the entire petal. I'm going to wipe it back towards where I want the darkest to be. And we'll flip it around and do the other flower. All right, so I'm liking the leaves how I have those for right now. So I'm going to leave those. We're going to let this dry, and then we'll come back and we'll put the center in the flowers. So I've let it dry mostly. It's not completely flat yet, so it's not all the way dry, but I want to add a little bit more of our darkest color in there, which was 67, and add a little bit more. I'm thinking I need a little bit more of that on here. I'm going to get this edge wet, and then I'm going to kind of swoosh it back towards the edge of that petal. This one's got kind of a little fold right here, so let's bring this up, and then I'm going to bring it out. I'm going to get some water on my brush. Again, bring this out just a little bit, soften that edge, and then kind of push it back towards that edge of that dark where I want it to go. This petal up here, let's go along this edge. And then I'm going to rinse my brush off and dab it on a paper towel, get some of the excess water off, and go in here. And then swoosh back. And let's see, we've got this one. And this one kind of comes over the top of it, so let's go down into here. I'm going to rinse my brush because I've got a little bit of blue on there. I don't want that on there. And bring in just some water. And push it back towards the dark section. And this little part right here, I think I'll put a little bit more this darker blue in here. And let's flip it around and we'll do the other one. And I got quite a bit of blue there, so I'm going to rinse my brush off, get some clean water. Soften that edge. And I'm going to wipe it back towards the dark section. All right, I'm gonna let that dry and I'll be back. So I'm back. I've allowed that to dry and I'm going to add some color to the center of my flowers. For that, I'm going to use number 42. Put quite a little blob on there and let that dry. All right, let's see here. So our petals on our flowers. I'm thinking maybe I'm gonna add just a little bit more blue to a couple of these, the darker blue. And let's do a little bit of water. And I think I'm going to pick up a little bit more of my medium blue. And maybe put that on there. And then let's pick up some of this lighter blue and see what that does. I think I'm just going to try it on this flower and see how the difference it makes from this one and the other one over there. All right, so we're going to let that dry. All right, guys, so I've let my flowers dry and I'm really liking how they turned out. So I am going to leave them like this and I'm going to make a card with them that I will post over on the store blog. I'll put a link to that down in the description box if you'd like to go check that out. But these are all the flowers on this page have been hand dried. And then this is the one I did beforehand that I dried it with the dryer. So you can see that there's a complete difference in how, if you just let it sit there and dry, it will get a complete different look than you will if you dry it with your heat tool so that it's faster. So I hope you had fun watercoloring with me today. If you have a question, leave me a comment and I'll make sure to get back to you. Otherwise, we'll see you next time. Have a great day. Bye.